Imam Zaid, an amazing talk by Ustadh Ali Atai, that if we can digest that, I think that that should be enough for the remainder of Ramadan and the next few months, inshallah. May Allah bless him, may bless his family. And we are really blessed in this community to have such esteemed scholars amongst ourselves. And may Allah give us tawfiq as well to benefit from their knowledge and to implement this knowledge in our daily lives. One of the things that really amazed me tonight as I was doing tarahweeh behind the Qari Amr, obviously, an amazing voice, beautiful voice. May Allah bless him and his family. Qari Tayyib, when he was reciting, and every time that he would get stuck, he couldn't go forward. And it just hit me that, subhanAllah, look at the truth of this Quran, this book, that when there's a mistake, he can't go forward. He always would retract back and go to the point of the mistake, and then he would retract back, and he would go to the point of mistake until he would get it. And then he would go forward. I said, subhanAllah, look at that. Allah is not even allowing him to go forward because he has the Quran in his heart, and the heart has been purified. You can only do good. And then, you know, one of the things Dr. Atai and Imam Zaid were talking about, the truth of this religion, and we are forgetting about sometimes with all these madness on television and on the internet against Islam, we're forgetting about the Imam Zaid. Last night we were with him, we had the blessing to be with him. He said something so amazing. He said that when the surah that Tabbat Yada Abi Lahab wa Tab was revealed, and Dr. Atai talked about it, that may the hands of Abu Lahab be perished. And like he says, Abu Lahab was done. He was done, khalas. The Quraysh went to him and they said, listen, Abu Lahab, you can nullify the whole message of Muhammad. You can destroy this religion. It's done. Just go and take your shahada. Just say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, the message is done, because the Quran says you are done. You're going to the fire of hell. But if you say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, then all your sins are forgiven according to the religion of Islam. Because now you're becoming Muslim. Because Islam deletes everything that was in the kufr, right? Even Bahshi, when he became Muslim, after killing Sayyidina Hamza, he became Muslim. Everything is past is wiped out. Hind became Muslim. It's done. Abu Sufyan became Muslim. It's done. Ikrimah became Muslim. It's done. Khalid ibn Walid became Muslim. It's done. The past is done. He said, just take your shahada. That's all he has to do. Just say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, and Islam is done. He couldn't say it. He couldn't say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Had he said it, it would have been done. But look at it, that's the truth of this religion. That is the truth of Islam. That he couldn't say, La ilaha illallah. They begged him. He couldn't say it. But anyways, we are in the month of Ramadan, and it's a blessed month. And one of the things that you can feel, the nafs is getting weak during this month. So everybody's establishing the prayers and reading Quran, and you know, everybody's. And then in a few days when Eid comes in, unfortunately many people will leave and start going back on their daily life. And the nafs is something amazing that Allah has created. Sayyid Nursi Badiul Zaman says in his Risala on Ramadan, he says, when Allah created the nafs, he said, who are you and who am I? And the nafs says, ana ana wa anta anta. I am me and you're you. And Allah then punished the nafs. And then after the punishment, he says, who am I and who are you? He says, ana ana wa anta anta. I am me and you're you. So he did it a few times. Every time he punished the nafs, he said the same response. And finally, Allah starved the nafs. He starved it from food. And then he said, who am I and who are you? And he said, Anta Rabbi Rahim, wa ana abdul ajiz. You know, you are the Lord, you are the merciful Lord. Ana, alas, abduka al ajiz. I am your servant. I'm ajiz, alas. That's the treatment of the nafs. You have to starve it. You have to say, Mawlana Rumi, when he was doing the masnavi, he was all coming to him. And Chalabi was writing his student and Sultan Wala, his son, they were writing whatever he was saying. Every time he ate, he said, it's all fuzzy, I can't think, I can't say anything. So they would stop, and then when he would get hungry, then he would get this ilham and he would start mentioning these verses of Mathnawi, and they would write it down. But the nafs is a, you know, Mawlana Rumi has a beautiful poem about the nafs. I mean, his poems are all beautiful, but he has a story actually about a man who was running away from his enemy. And he tried to run away from this thief who's an enemy and a thief. And so he went home and he goes inside his house and he locked the door. And Mawlana says, Dar bibasto dushmanan dar khane bud. Hile Fir'aun zin afsane bud. Sad hazaran tifl kush an kine kash. An ki umi jost an dar khanash. He said he shut the door, but the enemy was inside the house. And that was the trick of Fir'aun, was like that. He killed 100,000 tifl, 100,000 kids he killed. But the one that he was seeking was inside his house. That's your nafs. What he's saying is that is the nafs. No matter, you can't run away from it. He's inside the house. He is inside the house. You cannot run away from it. If you run away from him, you're running to him. There's no way. You can't go anywhere to avoid your nafs. It's always there with you. But you can starve it. You can control it. Don't let it get the control of you. Don't let it control of you. These are blessed nights that we can control our nafs, inshallah. But you know, my worry is a week from now. You know, the nights are going to get longer. But what good is the long nights, like the Persian poet says? He said, Shabhai daraz bi ibadat chi kanam. Tab'am ba gunah karda adat chi kanam. What should I do with these long nights without worshiping Allah? My habit is to sin and disobey God. What should I do? What should I do? Guyan kareem ast o gunah mi bakhshad. Giran ke bakhshad ze khajalat chi kan. He says, they say that he's kareem, he's generous, and he forgives. What if he forgives? What should I do with the humiliation of the sin? That I'm sinning against Allah and he's forgiven. What should I do with that humiliation? The humiliation of sinning against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Against Allah, the one who's providing us everything, the blessing that he has given us, the fact that we are here. This is one of the great blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brotherhood, sisterhood, the masjid, Ramadan. What a great blessing this month of Ramadan. That the previous ummah, they would die to have this month. This is why Allah veiled it. And the unveiling happened during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a grand finale, that this is the month. That this is like someone said, that this the month of Ramadan is like Yusuf alayhi salam. 12 brothers. But this month is like Yusuf alayhi salam. If you worship, you will become like Yusuf. You can take advantage of this month and become like Yusuf alayhi salam if you take advantage of this month. Because this month is every moment of it. The sleep of the fasting one is ibadah. When can you sleep and get reward for it except in this month? Look at this, and it's all bonuses from Allah. Allah just gives us all bonuses. Courtesy, why? Because membership has its privileges, like Dr. Atai said. Because of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are all because of him. All courtesy, it's the Prophet sallallahu habibullah. So he's doing it, giving it to us because we are from the ummah of habibullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what a great honor to be from his ummah. Wallahi, what a great honor to be from his ummah. And what a great honor to be part of this this community here. You know, we have, you know, scholars like Dr. Ali, Imam Zayd, Shakir, Sheikh Hamza, Yusuf, all these, we are blessed in this community, wallahi. We're completely blessed. I mean, I didn't come here tonight to talk. I actually came to listen to Sir Ali, Imam Zayd, but Sidi Yusuf asked to say a few words, inshallah. It's a beautiful night, so we should spend a little bit more time in ibadah in these last few nights. Ramadan is leaving us, and may Allah accept our worship for this month, and inshallah, And if you're alive to see next year's Ramadan, it'd be a great blessing. If you have to leave and depart this year, may Allah take us with full iman, inshallah. And the last word that comes out of our mouth, we kalimat la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad wa ala alayhi wa sallam.